As many of you now know, I recently acquired an electric eel, wild caught. Adding him to the tank was, of course, successful, but he hadn't eaten for several days. We all know that when you get a new fish, one of the things you want to make sure they're doing is, of course, eating. Now, along with a lot of other things, there are different methods of fish keeping, especially based on your location and the fish you're keeping, that will contribute to the success of your fish. And when it comes to diet specifically, I believe you should keep fish that you can provide for properly, including their diet, feeding them foods that you can actually get on a consistent basis. There's nothing worse getting a fish and they need a specific food and you can get it, but they're out of stock, or maybe you're feeding live cultures and the whole culture dies off, or something like that might happen. So for me, I want my fish to be able to eat. I demand them to eat what I'm able to source locally and consistently. Now, I don't expect the eel to eat dry foods right away. Do I think I can eventually get him onto them? Yes. But for the most part, I want him to eat shrimp, tilapia, everything that I can provide on a consistent basis. So I tried dropping it in the tank. No luck. Wasn't going after it. Nothing at all. I tried putting it on tongs and feeding it to him right to his mouth. Again, nothing happened. He wouldn't go after it. He wouldn't eat it. I tried splashing it around in the water. Again, wouldn't eat it. Now I'm starting to panic. I need you to eat. I need you to be healthy. I need you to be strong. You just come off the shipping. You know, I really want you to survive. I really want you to be healthy. I really want you to thrive. And then I thought, maybe he just can't taste what I'm putting in the water. But I did also notice that he's kind of skimming the sand with his chin, almost looking for something to stuff in his mouth. I thought, I'm going to stuff some shrimp in the sand, and then I'm going to pour some like shrimp juice into the tank so he can taste there's something in here. That worked. He ate. And now when I drop the food in, he just goes right after it. Continues looking for it as well. I typically feed him about 5 shrimp every day, but obviously I'm going to start gut loading the shrimp in terms of taking a piece of shrimp, stuffing it with a pellet, so making sure he gets all of his nutritional diet needs. This stuff right here is really good for that. So just take one of these pellets, stuff it into the shrimp, and eventually he'll get less and less shrimp, and I bet you I can get him on pellets like I do everybody else. We'll see long term how he does, but for the time being, you guys are probably wondering what's going on with the tank. I have added a few things to the tank and removed some. I ended up adding some Indian almond leaves or catalpa leaves, but I found that it was kind of messy. He didn't really go near them, and I knew that eventually they're going to rot in the tank and I'm going to have a big mess to clean up, and that's not going to be something I'm going to want to do with a massive electric eel in here. I'll also note that I can put my hands in this tank at any time, and he doesn't electrocute me or anything like that. You have to touch them, and or, you know, I guess you could probably irritate them or scare them and maybe they'll put off an electrical pulse, but this is actually the first time he's gone near these pipes too. He doesn't seem to go in them. He doesn't seem to swim in them. But he does seem to stay over here behind all these plants as opposed to coming over here. Either way, though, I put them in here just to see what he would do. It looks like he might. No, maybe he'll go in that one. It doesn't look like he needs these things. It's interesting that we often think that fish need certain things or want certain things or give them things to hide in or pipes to swim in. And it doesn't. I've never seen him in these pipes. These are just 4-inch ABS pipes. They've been in here for 3 days. He just doesn't go in them. Did you just go in that one? Well, I guess he goes in them. I was wrong. It seems like he likes it too. Or maybe he's just exploring, but this is literally the first time I've seen him in one. Does he need these? I don't think so. I think that he does need some plant cover because he does seem to like it. But to be honest, he's swimming through these, but I do think he's actively looking for food because I was just feeding him. Anyways, I knew that you guys were looking for an update on this electric eel, and I had to get this video out. Obviously, we've got a lot going on in the gallery, and I got to get back to it. So if you want to see what's going on with this new racking system or anything else, make sure you're subscribed if you're not already. I'll see you guys in the next video.